Someone cut down all my trees, and they're taking them away. They cut down my trees, they're taking them away. Hey, man, I just made my last payment on those. I just made my last payment on those trees. Now they're leaving. Aw, man.
Nah, I'm just joking.
We had Jake's Tree Service from Holly, Minnesota, come over to the house today, this morning. He said he'd be here at 8, and he was here at 7:55. And he took down some trees. There was a tree here. It was causing a situation. We're having a new roof put on the house. Because it's overdue. But we had to get the trees that were on it away from it. So we're gonna walk around this way so we stay out of their way and we can get a good view of what they're doing over here. I'll go like this. Whoa. And the squirrels are freaking out. There, the guy working the saw, that is Jake himself. He's doing it. So if you're in the Fargo-Moorhead area, you need to get some trees handled, give this guy a call. You got to give him a heads up though, because he is so good that he's backed up. He's swamped. And that's what happens when you provide good service. So walk around this way, see what else got going. They did. We had them take a little bit off here as well. That looks pretty cool. I've ridden in one of these things, and I was putting windows, storm windows, out at the farm, and it was on a windy day, and boy, I did not like it. So I reckon you get used to it, though, huh? Eventually. Got one of his workers back here doing his thing. They got a ton of branches too. Let's walk around the front of it. They've got a ton of branches too to chop up. Oh, chip over the logs, Todd. I gotta finish painting the house. Look at all those trees. Holy crap. That's a lot of trees. Gonna make a big difference too. Big difference up there. So let's take another walk around. Got another nice truck there. Got really nice equipment. That's part of it, having the right equipment to do the job. There sits the Fiero. I haven't even addressed the gasket on it yet. Guys putting in work, getting done. Taking another walk around, man. We'll zoom in and see where he cut some stuff off here. Up there. And he was way up there. He was all over the place, man. I gotta trim these bad boys up. I like to take these out and put up a fence, a 6-foot fence all around, so that Violet could run. And then, yeah, he chopped off some tree way over here, and I hooked it up. But right here, this is the part that shocked me the most, was, you see how the grass is dead right here? It's because there was no sun getting to it. But the fact that this tree's gone now just opens up this whole corner so much, it's ridiculous. You know, it's crazy. What I'm a little frightened of now. I'm gonna have to worry about the grass drying out, you know, like everybody else. See, I've got green grass. Everybody else is all dead. And it's just because I had the shade of the trees, right? So now I'm gonna have to bust out the sprinkler system and get it going. He's up there doing the... Oh, he was using the leaf blower up there. That's what it was. I need to get up there and do my gutters. Look at that, folks. I've got little green plants growing out of my gutters. Oh no, that's so not good. So not good. Yeah. Never said I was perfect, man. So, all right, well, I think we can stop there. I'll come back and show you what it looks like when it's all done. But what we've got here is Jake's Tree Service. Check it out. 218-277-9444.
After the fact, they're not actually like close to the tree.
Oh, okay.
But even right now, I mean, you can see all of this hay in here. So we'll put this up in here.
So there's the hole out to the other side.
Yep.
And when you look up, so it's tough to see in there,
but it looks like it goes pretty far.
Yeah, that's decay all the way up in there.
Wow.
And then if I go a little bit further yet,
so yeah, you can tell.
Can you see how far up that goes?
Yeah, it's all the way.
Wow.
That is a hollow tree.
And
how about down? Is it easier to get through the other side?
Yeah, it's a bigger hole. I think looking down, so all of this.
Yeah.
I mean, it's probably full a good couple feet down with just all of this.
Okay.
You know, fake wood stuff.
Yep. Wow.
So this goes...
into the middle?
Yeah, it goes in about a foot.
Crap.
If we go in here, we probably can't get another that solid. That's pretty solid in there too. But that initial hole that we looked up...
So it's going up minimum to there.
Probably 3 or 4 feet up. It's too small.
Holy.
This goes
it's hard to tell how far up it goes so far. It goes up so far that you can't tell.
Yeah,
wow.
There's the edge of the wall.
Mm-hmm.
And going up, I mean, it's still black in there. And right now, it's tough to tell if all these hands are crawling on me. So yeah, I can still go up and can't see anything, and we're
about a foot and
half up.
Yeah.
So we're at least there. I'd be willing to bet that the decay goes almost up to that union right there.
Yeah.
So, and like I was telling you before, I always hate telling people when, you know, that they should or they have to remove a tree, but I think this might be one of those cases.
Yep.
It's not necessarily the end of the world, being that it's a basswood.
Uh-huh.
Because they're kind of weak-wooded trees anyway.
Okay.
You know, if you were losing a big oak or a maple tree back here, I think that would be more of a sad day than losing a basswood. You know?
All right. So then what does a guy do? Just plant another one right over there?
Yeah, really. I mean, you could plant...
Or plant a different tree.
Yeah. If you want something that's really, really broad, I mean, you could do another silver maple, you know, which is like that over there.
Yeah. And put it, like, in the middle.
Yeah.
So that it has room to grow and move. Okay.
That and those grow relatively...
All right, so while they're outside doing their thing, working on their trees, I need to come back down here and get to work. So, let's go over here. Picked up a whole bunch of stuff yesterday, but we're not going to get into that right now. I'm going to get over here and get back to shipping this album. Almost done with this one. Got those ready to rock. Got a few more to go. So, there you go. I'll be back. All right, guys. So, it looks like... they're just about done. They're finishing up, getting the last little bits of stuff cleaned up. Doing a great job. Looks outstanding. We're gonna take another walk and see what we see. Wow, look at that. That is awesome. Well now, I'm gonna have to come out here with the hedge trimmers and do a little hedge trimming. I can reseed my grass because now it can grow because the shade's not gonna be on it as much. That tree's gone, so that looks great. Walk back here. Dun, 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 dun. Wow. Look at that tree standing all there all by itself. And that is a big tree. Super cool. And they did a really good job cleaning up back here. I haven't done anything with the yard in the last probably 2.5 weeks. I got stuff that's terrible over here because it's been so hot. I just let the grass grow because I don't want it to tend to mess up. So yeah, the trees turned out nice. They're all off the house, so now the roofers can come and do their thing. Jake's Tree Service, I'll go ahead and zoom in right here. We'll zoom right there. So if you're in the Fargo-Moorhead area, Dilworth, Glendon, Frazee, I'm not sure how far it already travels, but if you need a guy to do the job right and his helpers and clean up after the fact, call Jake's Tree Service at 218-277-9444. All right, guys. I just got back from the post office. Now it is time to move the little truck back into its spot and get back to work. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.